Hello students, very good morning. Welcome to Narayana Live Classes. Today for class 10 students, we are going to discuss assignment number 23 on differentiation. Let us start with the first question. If y is tan inverse of cos x by 1 plus sin x, what is the value of dy by dx? Okay, so using derivative of inverse trigonometric functions, we can do it. But here cos x by 1 plus sin x function can be further simplified. How can you simplify that? Let us take cos x by 1 plus sin x. Cos x we can write as, see, cos square x by 2 minus sin square x by 2. Using multiple angles concept, we can write it like that. 1 plus sin x can be written as, see, sin x is 2 sin x by 2 cos x by 2. 1 can be written as sin square x by 2 plus cos square x by 2. Overall, we can write it as cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 whole square. Further, if you simplify that, it is going to be cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 into cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2. So, this is nothing but cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 into cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2. Upon, here it is cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 whole square. So the square and this term will cancel. We are left with cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2 by cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2. Both numerator and denominator, if at all you divide with cos x by 2, we are going to have 1 minus tan x by 2 by 1 plus tan x by 2. That is otherwise tan pi by 4 minus x by 2. 1 minus tan x by 2 by 1 plus tan x by 2 is given by tan pi by 4 minus x by 2. So, if at all I write it here, my y will become tan inverse of tan cancels, it is simply pi by 4 minus x by 2. My y will change to pi by 4 minus x by 2. What do you need now? Dy by dx. So, dy dx of constant 0 minus dy dx of x by 2, that is 1 by 2. Dy dx of x by 2 is 1 by 2. So, the option for this question is, answer is minus 1 by 2. So, option is third option. Third option is the right answer. First we have simplified this, then we have applied derivative on both the sides. Fine. Let us see the next question. If y is equal to 2 power x by log x, then dy by dx at x is equal to e is. Let us see this. Y is given as 2 to the power of x by log x. This is a problem based on chain rule. Fine. Now dy by dx, we are differentiating both the sides with respect to x. That is, dy dx of this is 2 power x by log x into log 2 into dy dx of x by log x. Chain rule we are applying. First we have applied for 2 power x. It is something like 2 power x. Derivative of 2 power x is 2 power x log 2. For this function again you have to differentiate. This is a chain rule concept. That is otherwise 2 power x by log x into log 2 into, it is in the form of u by v, quotient rule. So what do you get now? Log x into derivative of numerator 1 minus x into derivative of log x, that is 1 by x by log x whole square. This is the quotient rule, d by dx of u by v. V into d by dx of u minus u into d by dx of v by v square. That is nothing but 2 power x by log x into log 2 into, here it is, log x minus 1 by log x whole square. This is the value of dy by dx. Now what is asking us? Dy by dx at x is equal to e. So dy by dx at x is equal to e. That is given by, see, this is 2 power e by log e. 2 power e by log e into log 2 into, here it is, log e is 1. So 1 minus 1, 0. So this entire value becomes 0. So this is 0 into 0. So finally the result is how much? 0 for us. 0 into any finite value is results in 0. So the answer for this question is 0 is nothing but fourth option for us. That is the right answer, right? Let us see the next question. If y is equal to e power x minus e power minus x by e power x plus e power minus x, then what is the value of dy by dx? Now, so y is given as e power x minus e power minus x by e power x plus e power minus x. Now, what is dy by dx for us? U by v rule does apply. E power x plus e power minus x, that is v into du by dx. For this, you have to differentiate, that is e power x plus e power minus x. Fine. Similarly, minus e power x minus e power x minus x times of derivative of numerator. Sorry, derivative of denominator. Derivative of denominator becomes e power x minus e power minus x upon e power x plus e power minus x whole square. So we are applying quotient rule. V into u dash minus u into v dash by v square. That is equal to. This is nothing but e power x whole square. E power x plus e power minus x whole square. That is e power 2x plus e power minus 2x plus 2. Similarly, minus half here, it is in the form of a minus b whole square. E power 2x plus e power minus 2x minus 2 by e power x plus e power minus x whole square. Any cancellations if you see, these two terms will cancel, plus minus cancels, and 2 minus of minus is that plus 4 by e power x plus e power minus x whole square. This is what is left with us, that is dy by dx. But options are in terms of y square and all. Why is this? Y square if you do, what is y square? 1 minus y square, let us take one of them. 1 minus y square if you take, that is 1 minus y square means this one. E power x minus e power minus x by e power x plus e power minus x whole square. Simplify that, the LCM part becomes e power x plus e power minus x whole square. Numerator part is this minus this, nothing but the same condition we have four value. So 1 minus y square is becoming what? Dy by dx. So dy by dx value is how much? 1 minus y square, that is third option for us. That is the right answer. This is one way. Otherwise, this function we can write as tan hx. Tan hx is y. So dy by dx is derivative of tan hx. That is secant h square x. Secant h square x is nothing but 1 minus y square. That way also we can solve it. Now let us see the next question. D by dx of log of x plus root over x square plus a square is equal to, here if you observe, derivative of, this is also a composite function, chain rule. Okay, this value. First we do for log function. Log derivative is 1 by x, 1 by x plus root over x square plus x square. I am continuing this. Okay, into. Now d by dx of what to write? X plus root over a square plus x square. Inner function we have to differentiate. Chain rule procedure. That is 1 by x plus root over a square plus x square into. It is like derivative of one function plus second function. Derivative of x is 1. Derivative of again root over a square plus x square. Again chain rule will come into picture. That is, okay, 1 by 2 root over a square plus x square. That is the derivative of root. But again you have to differentiate a square plus x square. That becomes 0 plus 2x. Chain rule concept. So what do you have now? That is 1 by x plus root over a square plus x square times of here 2 and 2 cancels, and if you add up these two, you are going to have x plus root over a square plus x square by here it is root over a square plus x square. These two terms cancel and we end up with 1 by root over a square plus x square. So dy by dx value is how much? 1 by root over a square plus x square. It is a problem based on chain rule. Okay. So that is the end of this assignment. Thank you. Have a great day.